In this video, we are going to discuss spiritual reading. And after that, I'm going to share with you what I think is probably the best spiritual literature written in our times. It has the power to renew the priesthood and therefore renew the church. But first, let's discuss spiritual reading. Spiritual reading is very important because we have access to spiritual giants. There's this saying that you cannot make another person hot if you are cold. How am I going to have my heart set on fire unless I get close to those who are on fire? And St. Alphonsus Liguori said that besides the sacraments, we need two things. We need prayer and meditation, and we need spiritual reading. Because it's spiritual, and if we pray before we read it, God will enlighten our minds, will inspire our hearts, He'll instruct our ignorance. Saint Dominic was said to have clutched books close to his chest and say, "This is my spiritual milk." Many of the saints have been converted because of spiritual literature. Saint Ignatius of Loyola, very famous for having a conversion after reading on the lives of the saints. Now, all spiritual literature is not created equal. Obviously, first and foremost, we have the most holy scripture, which is the Bible. We have the life of Jesus Christ. Everybody knows the quote from St. Jerome that ignorance of scripture is ignorance of Christ. In scripture, not only do we learn about the life of Christ, but the voice of God speaks to our hearts. It nourishes our souls. But there are other spiritual literatures. So, for example, the lives of the saints. Many individuals have been edified, have been strengthened by looking at the examples of a saint. In addition to the lives of the saints, we have the writings of the saints. The saints are our guides to heaven. The saints are Christ in action among us today for our times. So reading their writings is a sure guide to spiritual growth, and we need this frequently. What's better than reading the life of a saint? What's better than reading the writings of a saint? How about reading the writings of a saint about another saint? I'm talking about books like The Life of Saint Anthony by Saint Athanasius, or The Life of Saint Francis of Assisi by Saint Bonaventure. If the writings of the saints about saints is very good, could you imagine if there was writings of the saints about the greatest of all the saints? The best Marian literature has been written by saints. I encourage you to read the writings of Saint Louis de Montfort. I encourage you to read the writing of Saint Alphonsus called The Glories of Mary. So often we fail to hear the beauty preached about how great devotion to the Virgin Mary is. So we need to nourish ourselves with the writings of the saints on these topics. In addition to the writings of the saints, we also have books that the saints read. For example, I really love The Story of a Soul by Saint Therese, but guess what? What book did Saint Therese read that helped to nourish her soul? She and her entire family read The Imitation of Christ. Saint Francis de Sales has a great book called The Introduction to the Devout Life. Saint Francis de Sales is a doctor of the church. I would recommend that you read his writings. But what book did Saint Francis de Sales read? He was said to have carried around a copy of The Spiritual Combat by Dom Lorenzo Scopoli for over 18 years. So what did the doctors of the church read? Let me read that. In addition to these types of books, I recommend reading spiritual manuals. My favorite book on the spiritual life is called The Spiritual Life. It's a treatise on aesthetical and mystical theology. It's written by Tanqueray. This kind of book is very important for priests, especially because they have the responsibility of forming and educating souls, of being spiritual directors. This type of book is also very good for lay people. It's very important that we form ourselves. Now, the book that I made this video to endorse and to promote, this is the book that I think that you should buy your priest. Every seminarian needs a copy of this book. What is this book? It's called In Sinu Jesu. It is a journal of a priest, a Benedictine monk. He's having interior locutions. I suppose this would fall under private revelations from Jesus, and this is very recent. It started happening in 2007, and these are journal entries of his. Now, you might be thinking, private revelation, Gabriel, what's wrong with you? Hey, this book has the Nihil Obstat. It's got the imprimatur. It's been endorsed by Raymond Cardinal Burke. It's been endorsed by Hugh Barber, who was the prior of the Norbertines. All solid Catholics. There is no theological error in this. It's not asking you to believe in some weird apparition. It's a journal of a priest at prayer. And the beautiful thing about it is it's the kind of book that's gonna pierce the heart. So too often in the priesthood, as Jesus complained to St. Margaret Mary, there's not a real relationship with Jesus really present in the Eucharist. He's often neglected by those who are called to love him the most, and their neglect spills onto the people. So if we can ignite the flame in the heart of a priest for love of Jesus in the Eucharist, you're gonna set the church on fire. So the way this book should be used, it should be used in the Adoration Chapel if possible. If you're not in the Adoration Chapel, this book will drive you to the Adoration Chapel. Like any spiritual reading that you do before the Lord, you acknowledge the presence of God first, and you read it in His presence with Him, asking Him to speak to you through it. And it's not a book that you read from cover to cover. You really just read a chunk of it. And I'm going to share a passage with you. So imagine if you're there before the Blessed Sacrament, you've had a long day, you're weary, and you hear these words, you read these words as if Jesus himself were saying them to you. I am here in the sacrament of my love to be your comfort, your peace, your light, your refreshment, and your joy. Now, when you read these, you will notice if you're before the Blessed Sacrament that you're going to look at the Eucharistic face of Jesus, and not only are you going to read these words, but you're going to feel this in your heart. I am here in the sacrament of my love to be your comfort, your peace, your light, your refreshment, and your joy. Know this, take it to heart, believe it, and act upon it. If souls believed this of me, nothing would be able to keep them from seeking me out in the sacrament of my love and from remaining in my presence. Even after 2,000 years of Eucharistic presence in my church, I remain unknown. I am forgotten, forsaken, and treated like a thing to be kept here or there, with little regard for my own burning desire to be present to my people in a visible way and to see them approach me and remain silent and adoring in the light of my Eucharistic face. Who can change this sad state of things if not my priest? Now, as all spiritual reading, there'll be something that stood out to you more at different times of your life. So again, spiritual reading is to educate us, to inspire us, to give us courage, to be an example to us from the lives of the saints, but it's also to nourish us from day to day, to pick us up when we're down. And I think that's what this book does. I encourage you, buy this book for your priest. If he doesn't read it, it's up to God and His providence to get him to pick it up. Buy it for your seminarians. Why? Because this book will help us to become more Eucharistic-centered. Now, I'm going to leave a list of various books on various topics in the description section of this video. If there are books that you like that I didn't include there, I would love to read them in the comments. What is your favorite spiritual book? And let's conclude in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for this opportunity to reflect on our faith. We ask you to be with us as we read holy books, to stir up in us a love for you, a love for holiness, and give us the grace of fortitude that we can do the right things in face of adversity. Blessed Mother, you love our souls more than any other mother could. You're the spouse of the Holy Spirit. We ask you to pray for us, intercede for us, that the Holy Spirit might stir in us, that we can lead holier lives and change the world through our little daily acts of sacrifice. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you all.